Good morning, my soccer universe. Today I'm in a different car, so I couldn't do it while driving, so let's get through it now. And then, I'm not sure how much I will say tomorrow, because today is the big match where I will be. Between LASK and Rapid, semi-final in the cup. That's a pretty huge match, but that also means that I probably will not have a chance of seeing anything, but yeah. Maybe I'll make a video like this tomorrow in the morning too. Yesterday I watched one match, of course, Milan against Udine, and boy, first half I would say it was okay. There was a new system with Milan, with having Cotrone and Piontek on front, and then Paqueta behind, which actually seemed to work quite well overall. The problem is that first Donnarumma had to be substituted with Pepe Reina. And that was already something that Pepe Reina makes me nervous every time he touches the ball. So that didn't work out well. And then, not enough with that. Just when you thought Milan really gets control of the game and the system is actually working, you know, 4-4-2 with a Diamond in the center, Bilia, then you had Calhanoglu. On the other side in Bakayoko. So that seemed to be okay overall, but then Paqueta goes out. Castillejo comes in, who actually played fine, but of course is not Paqueta. But what I liked most is that, at least in the first half, both Piontek and Cutrone really were working for each other, and that's how the goal came, where Udine just horrible defending. Cutrone can go past the defender, has enough time, puts the cross in, Piontek heads it, comes back to him, and is saved by goalkeeper, comes back to him, he just has to convert. It's 1-0, and I'm Piontek, yeah, very happy about that. Fortunately, it was not to be. Second half, Okaka comes on, and then Udine seems unstoppable going forward, and Milan was missing the options to really make a good change. And that kind of robbed me of the joy of the game. And that was really the game in the 60s was hanging really in the balance, where you could say, oh, it's either 1-1 or 2-0. Piontek has a huge chance to make it 2-0. It's just blocked. And it was so often that there were big chances that were blocked. And I think the luck that Milan had earlier this season with making late goals didn't come back. Gets blocked. Udine launches a great counter-attack, and I don't know why the slow players are in the back. And yeah, they make it 1-1, really nicely taken by Lasagna. I mean, the way he controls the ball and then from the air, was a great goal. And the game hung in the balance, with Udine really having great chances on the counter-attack, but also Milan having their chances, but most of the time shots got blocked. I mean, there was a huge one by Castillejo. I think Piontek had another one. Cotrone. It could have gone either way and ends 1-1, which feels like a loss, honestly, because I think the next game up is Juve and then there's Lazio. And now, if Lazio makes up the points, Milan is already in fifth spot. So they're hitting a rough patch almost at the wrong time of the season. So I'm not happy about that. Actually, quite depressed. Cagliari Juve ends with a 2-0 win for Juve. Didn't see highlights there. The Premier League, Watford Fulham 4-1. I think that probably also means that Fulham is now relegated. At least very, 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 very close to. And then Wolves United. Well, since Solskjaer got the job, United is not playing great anymore. We had United taking an early lead, actually having control of the game, at least from the highlights. Once Wolves get the equalizer, United is going nowhere and they end up losing the game 2-1. Also games in Spain, Atletico Madrid beats Girona 2-0, Espanyol Getafe 1-1. I don't know, maybe Getafe is getting nervous. And then the big one, it was late. Barca had within 60-70 minutes a 2-0 lead. Seemed too comfortable. They were leaving 2-1 at the half, and then Villarreal turns it around. A crazy equalizing goal where Ter Stegen is misjudging it. I think it was Langley who is far, 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 far away from defender, and from the outside it goes into a short corner. 2-2. It even gets 3-2. and 4-2 through Bakka. The goal by Bakka, that's what I was missing at Milan when he was there. I actually was very happy when he came to Milan, but didn't really go that well. And it's 4-2, and you think Villarreal wins that one. And then Messi comes on, and Messi does what Messi does. Is anyone better at taking free kicks? I mean, that free kick, he chooses the corner of the goalkeeper and right in the corner. I mean, the goalkeeper cannot even get there. And then Suarez with a drop kick goal, also great, deep in stoppage time, makes it 4-4. Absolutely crazy game. And lastly, two German Cup games that were yesterday. Paderborn has Hamburg, and it's 2-0 for Hamburg. That's the rematch of the big match fixing game, which happened a few years ago, exactly between those two. And Augsburg loses home to Leipzig 2-1. So yeah, Leipzig is also on. So Hamburg and Leipzig move on to the next round. Let's see how it will go tomorrow. I'm seriously planning a huge video that I will shoot on Thursday that will hopefully out on Thursday to round up all the games. Yeah, I'm wearing the Hurricanes today. They won yesterday. At least one team that won of mine. I was close to not wearing any soccer shirt today. In the evening, I will, of course, wear last gear to the game. I hope that they will make the playoffs, but it's a really tight race there, too. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Let me know what you thought about the games that were yesterday. I mean, the crazy between Villarreal and Barca, and for me, the disappointing one between Milan and Udine. I think Wolves United is also rather disappointing if you're a United fan. But yeah. With all that, I will talk to you soon. Bye. Hey there. I really hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, here are some videos and playlists that might be of interest to you too. Also, please consider subscribing to my channel as it will give you all the updates on my channel, all things my soccer universe. And with that, I want to wish you a wonderful day.